What's up? It's your girl Jay. God bless everyone. Welcome back to my channel. If you're returning and if you're new, don't forget to like, share, and smash that subscribe button and hit that bell notifications for updates on my content, where you will mainly see content about nursing, lifestyle, how-to videos, and much more. So if you like that, smash that subscribe button. So guys, so I haven't been on here in a minute, like honestly. I have been so busy because I've had like 3 weeks off from school, and I've just been trying to like just detox and rewind and basically just enjoy my time off. And I've just been preoccupied. My husband literally went on vacation with my son and I couldn't go because I've been just trying to get myself back together, my peace and everything, and just enjoying my time and then getting ready for semester two. So what will today's video be about? So today we're going to be talking about, did I pass my first semester of nursing school? As you know, I am already an LPN. By the glory of God, hallelujah. And as you know, and if you don't know, I am already an LPN in the state of Washington, and I graduated in 2021 around, I think it was like April or May. And then I started to work in long-term care for a little bit, and I got some experience, and then a couple things happened along the route. This journey hasn't been easy for me. I've been learning and I've been just trialing and error. However you say that, just, you know, it's been trial and error. But basically I want you guys to understand that as a new nurse, it won't be easy for us, and there's going to be a lot of rocks and stumps along the way. But just pick yourself up and just remember that everyone has been there at one point of their life, but there are many people who don't allow us to grow and learn the ropes. But don't let that stop you. So without further ado, that will be another video for you guys, but this video I want to talk about if I passed my first semester of nursing school. So yes guys, I did pass. It was a roller coaster. When I say roller coaster, I mean roller coaster, like literally guys, it was so crazy chaotic. I literally had endless nights of studying and I felt like it was never going to be over. I remember just like studying all day and just trying to get my son into pre-K because it was hard with him and I couldn't accomplish a lot because I had to like cook for him, keep him busy, make sure just having time to spend with him, like quality time with him. And I was feeling guilty because I wasn't able to give him the time he deserved and stuff like that. And then he was able to go into pre-K and start that. I was able to have more alone time, just able to finish more work while he was in pre-K because it was only half day. And there were so much assignments having to be done, so much reading, and just so much things, because as an LPN to BSN, they expect so much more from you. And sorry, I'm always touching my face. I don't know why my face feels like it's itchy when I'm on video. But yeah, they expect so much more from you, and the scope of practice is much more different. So there's a lot of work that has to be done at home for my program because it's hybrid. So that being said, you can probably imagine that it's so complex, and there was a lot of stuff that had to be done. And for that first semester, I had like, let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I had 5 classes, but it felt like I had 8. It was like a full credit, or like the amount of classes was equivalent to like full credits, or, you know, 12 to full-time student. And I wasn't working at the time because, like I said, it's gonna be another video, but I just had to stop working. It was really stressing me out. I was losing a lot of hair before school actually started because working in long-term care, it was so stressful. Literally, it's gonna be another video. I keep on saying this, but Literally, I was just so stressed out. So I wanted to just start fresh with school and not be stressed out and just make sure that I got the best experience and was successful in school because this was my end goal for me. Like, I want to be successful in this LPN to BSN program so I can later further my education and whatnot. So yes, guys. So as you know, for my first semester, I was taking Foundations of Nursing, and it was the lecture portion, it was the lab portion, and also the clinical. And then I was also taking, let me see what we got here, complex patho slash pharm. So this class for me was the hardest. I know it might sound silly because I'm already a nurse, but just sometimes you forget a lot of the stuff you learn. So I had to just think about it as review, like a lot of the professors would say. It's review, don't overthink it. You know it, you just have to like review it. So that concept, I held on to that very tightly, and I just said to myself, this I know, and now I have to put it into practice, and I have to just review it. So I started to do a lot of Kaplan review questions. I started to just review my complete bundle of nursing, or it was like complete school, I don't know, it's this book that Nursing in the Making, correct me if I'm wrong, comment down below, but it's just this book that I purchased from this one YouTuber or Instagram lady. She's called Nurse in the Making, and she has a spiral bound, and it is amazing. I was using that. I was using the Saunders book and Kaplan, and also what is that name? Level Up RN. She's super great too. And there's another one, I think it's Registered RN. But yeah, I was watching videos to just refresh my memory about the patho and the farm. And then I was taking also translating research into evidence-based practice. This class had me so stressed out because there was just so much, oh my gosh, it was annoying. There was a lot of essays that had to be written this first semester that was very time consuming. We had to follow a certain like format template. We had to do APA, the 7th edition, and we had to just do a lot of things a specific way. And if you didn't do them, then you would get points deducted. And it was just very frustrating because, just too much things had to be done this semester, so I didn't want to overwhelm myself with making videos for you guys. And I did make several videos, but I have to edit it, and I just haven't had time, so I've just had them backed up on my camera, and my iCloud is full now, so I have to just take time to either upload them or I don't know what I'm gonna do with them. But yeah, guys, so then I also took care coordination and interprofessional collaboration, and this class I've learned a lot. It was actually pretty interesting, especially when I went, what did I do? Oh, I actually sat with a care manager and a couple other things I've learned about care coordination. I honestly didn't really know too much about care coordination until I started taking this class. So it basically opened up my mindset and made me understand that there's many other jobs out there. If it's care manager, if it's care coordination. Okay, guys, so yeah, I had to understand that care coordination was population driven and community based. And then I had to remember that care coordination was acute care, and it was more like episodic or episodic. But there are two different concepts that I didn't know before. I mean, we briefly learned about it in the LPN program, but we didn't really go in depth. So then I was able to understand that care coordination was different than care management. And at first, it was kind of hard to grasp and understand, but then I was able to comprehend it and understand that they were two different things. They were not the same. So I learned a lot during that time. And overall, my clinical experience was all with family practice, care managers, and what else? I think it was internal medicine. Yeah, it was with a internal medicine care manager, and then I was with a primary care nurse. She was like the charge nurse or something. The first semester, my clinical experience was great. I learned a lot, and I think they were all I don't even know what to say anymore. But yeah, it was a great experience. But now it's take two. I'm going into my semester two, and I'm going to be taking several classes again. Let's see what we got here for the agenda. So let's see. I'm gonna be a junior two semester, and this time I'm going to be taking a couple other classes like health policy, advanced nursing management of childbearing and child rearing families, then childbearing family clinical practicum, LPN to BSN skills and stimulation lab, and promoting population health in the community, and promoting population health in the community practicum for LPN to BSN students. So I'm going to be taking 6 classes. It's like 12 o'clock at night. It has already been crazy. I have downloaded a digital planner, a PDF version, and I imported it into my GoodNotes, and I started printing out all my syllabuses or whatever, however you say that. And I put all the important dates on my monthly calendars, and I have that all set because on Wednesday is my first day back, and I'm super tired already. I have to do a couple readings tomorrow and do a couple other quizzes and stuff like that. So tomorrow will be a crazy day. And I'm sorry if this video is crappy, but I just want to let you guys know where I'm at. And guys, please don't forget to like, share, and smash that subscribe button. Hit that bell notification because your girl is out. Peace out. God bless, and get some rest. Ooh, that rhymed.